Okay, welcome back to part two. I hope you've all enjoyed part one. Wasn't that just a lot of fun? That was so much fun to paint this lovely hilltop with some snow and a lovely little cabin in the forest. All right, we'll continue on now with part two. And I suppose, look, we've a little cabin off in the distance here. I think we should get that in first. Yes, what do you think? Let's get that in. So I have now. I'll tell you my colors again, just in case you're only tuning in for the first time. I have titanium white, Naples yellow, cobalt blue, phthalo blue, a little cadmium yellow, which I don't think I'm going to need, to be honest. Little crimson, some burnt umber, and some black. A nice little palette there. Nice, small, simple palette. And I'm going to start off with my small stubby brush, okay? These are my very popular brushes. Everybody's talking about these brushes, they're famous. Stubby brushes, look. Nice small brushes, you can cup them in your hand and you can get lovely little effects with them. And once they wear down, they're lovely for trees, that type of thing, okay? So I'll just show you there now, okay? You see, this one is really, really worn down, you see? It's kind of chiseled in. Perfect for little bushes and trees, that type of thing. But when you buy them, they are just like this. That's what they're like when you get them. They're just regular flat synthetic brushes, but they have a lovely short handle. But once they wear down, they get lovely and kind of bushy. So excellent for trees and that type of thing. So yeah, if you want some of these, just give me an email and I can get them off to you. Right, let's get cracking. Let's have some fun. I'm looking forward to finishing this lovely painting. I'm going to just dampen my brush very quickly in some turpentine, which I have down here. So it's a little damp, just a little tiny bit of damp brush. And let's go into some burnt umber. Now, my paints are a little bit kind of crusty on top because I painted this first part about 3 4 days ago. So my paints are still here. As you can see, they're soft, but you have to kind of break through the top crust. Isn't that so cool? If these were acrylics, they would be completely useless. They would be rock hard and you wouldn't be able to do anything with them. Little Naples yellow, that's still nice and soft. Look, see? Isn't that just fantastic? That's the great thing about oil painting is you can just walk away and leave everything as it is and come back to it the following day. And everything is still nice and soft. Okay, now I made a mistake there because I was babbling on. Right, I'm going to put in the roof and it's kind of a dark blue in the photograph. You can see it there. It's kind of a rich, dark, bluey kind of a color, isn't it? Because there's snow on it, but it's in shadow. So let's try a little phthalo blue and some white. And I might try a touch of crimson, tiniest little touch. So I'm just going to break this paint here. There we go. And a touch of black, lamp black. Now, not too much black because it'll only go really grey on you. So I'm keeping it more kind of on the bluey side. And a little more touch of crimson. And let's try this now and see how this looks. You see, the trick with painting, I find with a lot of painting, is that you need to get light in front of dark or dark in front of light in order for something to show properly. So, for instance, on this, we have some dark trees at the background here, so I'm going to need something light in front of them, aren't I, to really stand out. And that's the trick I find painting a lot of these types of scenes. You need to put Just think about that when you're painting something. Is there going to be a light behind it or is there going to be a dark behind it, which is going to show up nicely? So bear that in mind when painting. Now I'm going to lighten it a bit more because there's snow on this roof. I'm just going to lighten it a little. Okay. All right, that's not bad. What we could do then is we can kind of create a gradient in the color. So let's imagine it's getting slightly darker the further left we go. So I'll take some phthalo blue with some crimson and I'll darken it. I'll start on the right hand side, look, and I'll just give it a little bit of darkness just in there. And then I'll soften that color across into the lighter color, you see? And it just gives it a bit of kind of depth or something. It's difficult to explain, but it really kind of pops out a lot more, I find. Now I'm adding a touch more crimson because it's a little blue there, isn't it? And then soften that across into that light color. And we can use our knife on this as well later, okay? So don't be too fussy with this. Let's put in the cabin, the wood. So I'm taking some burnt umber, a little crimson, and I'm going to just put in the front of the cabin here. If this is the front, I suppose. It could be the side of the cabin, I don't know. But let's just put this in here. Put that color in, bring it down just a little, and we go to the side. Now this is going to be in light, so I'm going to add some Naples yellow to that. In fact, let's take some crimson with some Naples yellow, and let's try that. I'm kind of trying different things now as I go here. Let's get some more Naples. Oh, my easel is moving back on its own. I have to tighten it, I think. One sec now. So I'll put this color in. Bring that down. It doesn't matter if you have other colours on your brush. Look, you see, I have a little bit of dark brown on my brush, but that's fine. That will actually help give some different tones in there, you see? That's lovely now, isn't it? Understand? Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to do the very same as what I did on the roof. So I'm going to take a little touch of that lighter colour, and I'm going to soften it into some of the dark here. And I'm going to soften that across into the darker shade. Okay? And perhaps even soften the line where they meet. Just a touch. How's that looking? Quite nice, isn't it? Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to tighten my easel because it's moving around here. I forgot to tighten it earlier. There we go, that's nice and tight now. I'm going to put some dark colour now in with some black, tiny bit of black, just at this side, and soften it across again. See? And that just helps gives you a little kind of contrast in there. The next step is I'm going to switch to a small pointy brush, and I'm going to dampen that and take some black and some burnt umber. And let's create some of the logwood on the cabin here with this. Look, just a couple of straight lines right across. And we'll do the same with this one here. I'm just going to go at a very slight angle upwards, just to show that it's turned. Okay, and that will give you some perspective also. Just put a couple of those dark lines in up there. Nothing too fancy, look at that, just nice and simple. And then I'll take some more burnt umber and go in under the eave of the roof here. Now I want to give it a bit of a shadow just in under that roof. And also just to separate the roof from the cabin, if you know what I mean. And then I'll take some black and go down under here with some black. Alright, would you like me to zoom in on this section for you? I'll zoom in, will I? So you can see much easier what I'm doing, because, you know, it can be annoying when you can't see close up what's going on. So look, how's that? That okay? Let's get some nice whitey blue now. Just a little bit of blue with plenty of white, and I'm going to put down on the other side of this roof here. There we go. Alright, and then clean our brush again, pick up some of the black, and let's put a little shadow in under that eave just there. So it's casting a shadow down onto the cabin. Isn't that easy? Now strangely enough, if you notice on the photograph, these little cabins don't have any chimneys or anything like that. I presume they have a little wood-burning stove or something inside. But, you know, I'm just going to copy it as it is. You could put a little chimney pot or something in if you wanted. You know, we still could. There's nothing saying that we can't. Should we put one in? Might make it look a bit more believable, wouldn't it? Let's just take a bit of burnt umber and put a little chimney pot in somewhere. Anywhere at all. Just to suggest that there is in fact somewhere for burning solid fuel. Let's get another one over here on this side. We'll put a little one, let's say just here, okay. Doesn't have to be a very fancy looking chimney pot. Alright, just like so. And we could even suggest later on, we could suggest a little smoke coming out of these pots. Wouldn't that be nice? Yes? That would be nice. Okay. That, I think, will do just fine. Let me just fix this line here. There. So I just put two chimney pots on these. Right. What have we got left to do here now? I think we have, let's put a little door and that kind of thing in here. So I'll take some burnt umber and some black. I'll put the door here. I don't know if you can see it on the photograph, but there's something here. It looks like a door. It's very kind of dark and you can't really make out much on the photograph over here. So I'll just indicate a door and a window, and I'll take some light blue and suggest. In fact, you know what we could do? Just popped into my head there now this minute. What about we take a bit of yellow, cadmium yellow, with some Naples yellow, and suggest a light coming from the window. How's that? So somebody's inside sitting next to the fire. Doesn't that sound lovely? There. And that's pretty much that one finished, I would say. I might just add a little more dark under here. And perhaps just at the outside corner there, suggest some thick wood part of the structure. And perhaps indicate one or two little things against the cabin. Just little, you know, they're nothing in particular, it's just little marks. Just to suggest that there may be little, you know, bits of wood and all that kind of stuff resting against the cabin. Now, I'm just going to darken this section here. I'm going to get some dark colour. So a little bit of Taylor blue with some crimson. Just darken this area here. Just to soften that in. There we go. That's that done. And the next thing I'm going to do now, I'm going to zoom back and get some nice snow on this foreground section here. So look, will I just zoom in on the photograph, the painting for now? And I can go back to my palette then. In a couple of minutes. Yes? Does that sound okay? Right. I just want to make sure now that I have a good angle on this for you, that you can see everything that's going on. Let me just turn on that slightly. That's better, isn't it? Now, okay. I'll use my small stubby brush first, just to create a bit of snow back here. I'm just going to dampen that. And I'm going to take some cobalt blue, plenty of white, and let's try that first. I want to go in here now and give that a bit of light, just a bit of light on the snow. This now, by the way, is all dry, just so you know, it's all completely dry. I'll take a bit of crimson in this. I've just darkened it very slightly, so I'm just kind of creating the impression of the snow, just some light spots on the snow here and there. I'm dragging it across and you can see it's kind of very dry on the canvas. I'm just letting the brush drag across and look, even blend it with your fingers here and there, just to create a bit of light on that snow. That's all. I'll take a touch more phthalo blue with crimson and I might add some shadow behind the cabin. Taylor blue with some crimson and a little shadow on this side of it here. So I'm just kind of flicking it along here and there, allowing it to sort of blend into that colour behind and softening it with your finger very slightly. I know you'll be giving out to me now about using my fingers on the painting, but look, I don't do very often. So don't be mad. Alright. Please don't be mad. Now I will put another bit of a shadow on this side. It's a very, just a very warm, dark kind of a blue. That's all it is. I'll clean my fingers now. Every time I'm doing this, I'm cleaning my fingers, okay? So don't worry. Right. I'll take a touch of black, I think, and a touch of phthalo. And I'm going to go right up there with some nice dark shadows. And the same on this one. Alright, how's that looking? Well, that's pretty good. And I might start adding some light onto our painting and cleaning this brush now very well. Good dry on the tissue. See, just relatively clean. And let's mix up a nice bright colour now for some snow. Let's take some white and let's get a touch of cobalt. I'll start with that. I'm not going to go very bright for now. Lots of paint on a dry brush, and I'm going to start adding just little ridges of snow here and there. Again, this now is all going to be just an impression. So don't be trying to make it look like anything in particular. Little ridges of snow against the side of the cabin, just there. Do you know, with a snow scene like this, the snow is very kind of higgledy-piggledy. It's just up and down everywhere. There's no kind of structure to it. So it's just a case, I find, of just flicking some snow across here and there. And just being very spontaneous. Be very spontaneous with your brush. You don't have to be too kind of being perfect like this. Do everything absolutely spot on. Just grab loads of colour and pull a lot of colour across here and there. And sometimes it can actually look more natural. It's a painting, it's not a photograph at all. Come on, let's just have a bit of fun with this. And soften some of that into some of the darks. Okay, so you can cut across here into some of the darks. Pull it down. Understand what I mean? It's just nice and loose. Nice and loose and free. So I'm going to put one or two bushes in. I think I'd like to put a couple of bushes in. One or two maybe just here. Small bushes. I'll take a small bush brush. Let me have a look for a bushy brush. Okay, this one. We also have a slightly bigger one. It's too big. I'll try this one first, okay? Let's just, with this dry brush, I'm going to take some black. And I'm going to take some phthalo blue. And a touch of crimson. So it's these three colours now for bushes. And I'm just going to come along here and put in the shape of a bush. Okay, just like that. One little bush, another one perhaps next to it. Okay, this is just a very, very dark colour I'm using. And perhaps we could put another little one here. And I'm just dabbing it very, you see? You see the way the hairs are very kind of splayed out. Let me show you. They're very kind of worn and splayed. That's perfect. That's what we want. And I'll add another one. Put another little one back here. So lots of kind of little bushes here and there. Look at the photograph now. We've one or two kind of small ones sticking around. There and there. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to clean this brush just very quickly, dip it in your turpentine and give it a very quick once, you see, and you take everything off then. Well, 90% of it is gone. Give it a good scrub. And there we go. Ready for use again. Then I'm going to take some cobalt blue with lots of white, perhaps even a touch of crimson. Let me just get this nice mix here now. Cobalt blue, plenty of white and crimson. It's almost slightly on the pinky side, if anything. And then I'm just going to go. Let me see now if you can see what I'm seeing here. Yes, you can. I'll zoom in slightly, look. Sorry now for all this zooming in and zooming out, but I really want to show you how I'm doing these bushes in close detail. So look, very kind of rough brush. All right. A nice pinky color on it. I'm just going to dab, 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 dab. Like that. just a little bit on one side where the light is coming down and catching it. So look. Dab, dab, dab. I move a little bit up here. Okay. And I reload my brush every couple of seconds. Just like that. Now you can even just use the corner of your brush as well for some pieces. Let me get some nice bright white on this one here. Alright, and then what I'm going to do is take my little flat brush and get some nice bright white and go in under these and just pull some of that along here, look, here and there. So that kind of sits the bush down then, doesn't it? See? It helps the bush kind of just settle down in the snow. And we put one here, a little bit across underneath. There now. So aren't they lovely? Lovely little bushes in the snow. Nice and simply done. So what's next? Let's have a look and see what are we going to do next. Okay, I think we'll continue now with this, bringing this down. I can always add, in fact, what I will do, I beg your pardon here now, I'm just going to take a round brush, medium sized round brush. I'm going to add some light onto this cabin here. Just with some Naples yellow, touch of white. Just from this side, I want to add some light and soften it into the dark then slightly. Okay, look. Just to kind of catch your eyes, that's all. Very simple. Look, just drag it across here and there. I just wanted to do that because it was just kind of very flat. It looked very kind of flat, and we can go back and do a bit more detail on this later. That's a little bit better, I think. Right, more of this colour. Let's get our large stubby brush. Lovely warm stubby brush. I'll dampen it very quickly and dry it on a tissue. I'll take some cobalt blue, little tiny bit of black, and plenty of white. Maybe a touch of phthalo as well. So a nice kind of a rich blue, rich bluey colour. If you find this too dry on the canvas, just add a tiny, tiny touch of Naples yellow, or a tiny touch of turpentine rather. God almighty, I'm very bad today. Let's get this nice and flowy now, yes? There we go, cobalt blue, loads of white. That's a nice colour. I just want to try and blend a similar colour into this. Pull that across, left and right. I'm just kind of flicking the brush now, very, very loosely. Soften it into some of the white there. That helps kind of blend everything back in together then, rather than having two completely separate colours. Now, we just... There we go. Soften it up into that kind of blue there. There we go. Now look at that. So now we have a lovely background in down here, don't we? I'm going to start adding some little touches of dark colour here and there. So some phthalo blue, some crimson again to warm it. I'm using crimson all the time just to warm the colour very slightly. And a touch of black, just a touch. And I might just kind of bring some of that across here and there. I'll be going over a lot of this now, don't worry. I just want to get some shadowed areas in for later. There we go. Alright, that'll do fine. There. No. So you can see now we have our kind of background colour done, don't we? And you could, if you wanted, start adding more little bushes here and there. What I might do, yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll add a couple of more bushes up here. Some phthalo blue, some black, and a tiny touch of crimson again. I'm just going to go along here and add A rough outline of a tree. Just a little tree. It could be any kind of a tree. It doesn't have to be a fern tree or anything like that. You know, there's lots of different types of trees. I know there'll be predominantly fir trees in a snow scene like this. So look, I'm just going to kind of indicate the impression of some little trees and bushes here and there. Right, I'll clean my brush again. Now you can experiment with different brushes on this if you like. You can just use your little tiny brush for flicking, or you can use a fan brush. That's another good brush to use. But just experiment with different types of brushes. You don't have to copy my brush techniques all of the time. So let's add a little bit of light into that and soften it into the darker area, just a little. It's just an easy way of doing a nice little bush. Let's put a little bit on this, a little bit of snow, a nice crisp white. See, just here and there. And let's take some very thick white, just on the very tip of the brush, just a little. Just a little. And then again, I'll take my small brush, take some nice crisp white, perhaps a touch of cobalt, and we'll cut in underneath some of these then, just to sit those down, and then soften that colour down into the colour underneath. See? Soften it right down. How about that? Now let's try painting a few little bushes with branches on them, yes? Let's take a small pointy brush, a very small pointy brush, and let's get some burnt umber with a little black and lots of turpentine. And come on, let's have a bit of fun with this. Alright, let's try a couple of little branches coming off. See? Can you see what I'm doing there now? Will I zoom back in slightly for you? There. You can see what I'm doing better now, can't you? And let's get a couple of little branches coming off of this. Loads and loads of turpentine in this now, nice and wet. And if you've shaky hands, that's all the better. Shaky hands are fantastic for this. God knows when I start getting old, they'll become more and more shaky and I'll be painting fantastic trees. Isn't that right? Let's put a little couple of flicks of grass popping up just here and there with our little point of the brush. Look, just little tiny little flicks here and there. Nothing too fancy. It's not even hitting the canvas half of the time. That's okay. Okay, let's put another little small little fella on this side. There can be little bits of tree on the ground, bits of broken off branches, tree trunk, that type of stuff, just kind of lying around on the floor. Alright. Okay. I'm just kind of making it my own. I know it's not in the photograph, I like to make things my own. Now what I want to do is, first of all, I'm just going to clean that brush. I'm going to take a little Naples yellow. I won't. Scrap that idea. Forget that. Let's just take a bit of white and add little touches of white here and there on the tree. Look, so snow is settling on the tree here and there. And even on this bit of a branch on the floor. Lots of snow settling around. And even soften some of it with your finger. Look, see? So it's almost merging into the landscape. It's merging into that steep snow underneath. There, see? Sometimes your finger is the best tool in your box, isn't that right? There. And you see now how that's kind of just really adding some little bits of detail to the painting. Let's come up here and add some more to this tree. Look, little bits of detail to that. couple of little spots of snow here and there, just kind of, you know, adding a touch of detail, that's all. And let's kind of put a couple of ridges of snow around here and there. All I'm doing is suggesting all of the time. I love to suggest something rather than paint. So for example, suggest a rock rather than paint every single little detail on a rock. Do you understand what I mean? That kind of idea. I love doing that kind of technique with painting. I find it just seems more natural for me to look at a painting and to see the suggestion of something. Now I'm just going to create a little ridge of snow down here. So I'm just going to kind of flick my brush at a slight angle upwards. So you see, I'm kind of softening all the time the brush into the colour underneath. Come down at a little angle there with that, see? And let's create a couple of little ridges of snow here and there. Look, lots of thick paint, look at that. Put on plenty of paint, that's lovely, isn't it? Look at that. And pull that across. The great thing about these oils is that you can really kind of soften a lot of colours together if you don't like what you're putting on. You see? You can soften it out, blend it out. Let's put in a little couple here and there. Again, it's light against darks, you see? I'm putting in little hints of lights against some of the darker colours. Just making it look busy. Like there's a lot of stuff going on. Let me just zoom back here so you can see. There now, that's a bit better, isn't it? How about, let me see here now, create the idea of a footpath, or we could even create the idea of some shadows behind some of the bushes as well. Can we try that? Let's try some phthalo blue, a little crimson, and let's try the idea of some shadows being cast by some of these bushes. Even this little tree here could be casting a little shadow. Alright. And underneath this. That's nice. And again, soften everything together. Nice and soft. There, that's a bit better now, isn't it? We could create a little shadow down here. Oh yes, I was saying about a footpath. Should we try and create the idea of a little footpath coming in? The ridge of a footpath, yes? So let's create, let's get some nice white. Let's take a touch of crimson and a touch of Naples yellow. And we could have a nice footpath now kind of winding around here. So it's coming around like this. And it's coming down here like that. And nice bright colour now on this. Okay. And then clean this, and I'm going to take some burnt umber with some black. And I'm going to go along then. And just follow that here and there. Soften it out. So creating the idea of a little trail of some sort. Now we'll walk away on this for a while, okay? Don't worry. It's not going to be like this. Okay, bring it up into the house, let it disappear. Of course you don't have to do this. You can make completely your own type of painting. You don't have to do this at all. Take a little bit of black with a pointy brush. And just a little, couple of little suggestions of the edge there. Now it's going to be covered in snow, obviously. It's just a suggestion. A very, very loose suggestion of a kind of a pathway going through the snow. In snow season, it's very difficult to pronounce something like this because there's so much snow around the place, isn't there? And I'll create a little bank just at the edge here where the snow's coming down. There we are. Softening everything back into the distance. And let me get some more white up here now. Perhaps a little here. Just nice, easy techniques. Now, I want to create some nice little grass, okay? I'll use a fan brush. Let's take a fan brush. Let's get some burnt umber, a touch of black, so a very dark color. And let's just create some little, it's not grass, but you know what I mean. It's breaking through the snow here and there. Understand? You get these little things in snow scenes, little, and you can even switch to your point, your brush. Get some little finer points on these. Okay, there we are, little grasses popping up here and there. And we could even create some snowy kind of ones. So you might even have some with some snow. Perhaps the snow just fell and they're covered in snow as well. Couple here and there. Again, I'll take my small brush after this, my little flat brush, and pop some white. Let's take a touch of cobalt in this. And let's just pop some white in underneath some of these and soften them down then. So it's always a good idea to kind of sit these things down on the floor by just popping some colour underneath them rather than just kind of letting them float in midair as such. So you see, I'm kind of sitting everything down nicely. Now I do want to create some very bright, nice sunlight on some of the snow here and there. So I'm going to show you now how I do this. With any type of painting that I do, it's pretty much the same principle in every painting. I'll take some crimson, just a little crimson now, lots of Naples yellow, and lots of white. Lots and lots and lots of white. And with that lovely kind of salmon type of a colour, I put some of that in here and there, see? Now the snow really begins to pop, doesn't it? Perhaps put a little over here and there. And it's a lovely way of suggesting sunlight hitting some snow. It's a lovely color because we have crimson in this mix, it's not going to turn green with the blue. Do you understand? So keep plenty of pink in this color. And you won't get any green on your canvas. So I'm just putting little flicks of it here and there, just to suggest real bright color on that snow. That's all. Again, you don't have to do this. You can leave it out if you don't want to do it. I quite enjoy getting this lovely bright color to sort of catch your eye in the painting. So now let's just sit back and take a look. Isn't that lovely? How about we put a nice big tree. Let's put a big tree in here, shall we? Now, first of all, before I do that, I just want to do more work on the roof over here. I want to bring this roof out just slightly, a little bit more. Just overhanging here, you see? Now that's much better, I think. A slight overhang. And then I'll go in underneath that with some nice dark colour. A little touch of black on a pointy brush. And pull that along. There we go. And also, Didn't we say we'd try some smoke from the chimney tops, didn't we? Would we try it? Come on, we try it. Let's go crazy and have a bit of fun. Right, I'll take a little white. Because we have white behind here, white smoke is not going to really show, is it? So I'm taking a touch of black just to make it a little on the grey side. Perhaps even a touch of brown. So I want a very, very light kind of a grey for the smoke. Now let's just try this first and see. Okay, I'll come off this now and just swirl it around, just barely touching the canvas. Okay, can you see that? And when I go up into the darker colour, I'm adding more white. I just picked up a tiny, tiny bit of white with my brush. So then we have the white against the dark blue, you see? Oh, how's that? And then even soften it with your finger in, look. Let it just disappear off into the sky. And we have smoke coming out of a cabin. Now we could try this one as well. Let's try it. So we have a dark colour behind this chimney top. So let's just take a little touch of white. A very light colour. And let's bring some white out of that. And as it gets up, perhaps pick up some of that darker colour. Some of the darker grey, you see? And darker grey goes into the white mist behind it then. Does that make sense? It's only a very, very faint impression now, that's all. There. That's lovely. Now you could add a little highlight to this smoke as well, because even smoke would have some highlights. So what you could do is take a little white and let's just add a little dab of highlight just here and there. Just kind of flicking the brush around. See? Very, very gently and barely touching the canvas. And there we have some nice highlight on this smoke. Very simple, but very, very effective. This is fun, isn't it? Now, I'm going to start painting a nice tree. A nice tree coming up in one side. Let's say here. Let's say this side here, okay? I'm going to take lots of burnt umber. Lots of burnt umber now and lots of turpentine. And some black. So make a nice, very rich, dark mix. And let's come over here now and let's put a nice tree in here somewhere. I'm trying to think, because I'm thinking of the composition. I'm looking at the composition. We have kind of a lot on this side of the painting, don't we? So I'm thinking, you know, perhaps around here, a nice tree coming up in the close-up foreground here. So let's just lean down hard and bring a nice tree up here. Don't worry, you won't spoil your painting. Make your painting your own. You don't have to just leave as it is on the photograph. Let's add a tree. So I'm just putting in the thick stump of the tree with this brush. Then I'm going to switch to a smaller brush. Now I switch to this one. Nice new brush I have here. I'm going to get some black and put some black down one side of this for a shadow. And soften it in slightly, just here and there. And then, let's put in some branches, yes? Let's get some nice small branches in here and there. And we could create the idea of the tree kind of falling over as well. So it's leaning into the painting. Will we try it? Let's just go right up here into that hill. And create the impression of the wind kind of... The wind perhaps is going in one direction most of the time. So the tree has been kind of blown right over at this kind of a peculiar angle. Does that make sense? And I'll put another nice branch off it down here, look. Just to give it a bit of balance. Balance out the tree nicely. This is nice now, isn't it? It's adding to the painting. And it's just little flicks with the brush coming off one another, you see? And put one or two just on this side here, look. Just one or two. Perhaps give it one or two down low. Little bits of things. We might have some little bits of grasses and stuff growing out at the base of the trunk, look. So let's put a couple of little flicks in there. And that also helps to sit the tree trunk, kind of plant it down in the floor as well, doesn't it? So you keep going with this now, having a nice bit of fun with this, learning about trees all of the time. And I'm going to bring it over a bit more there. No. Isn't that looking nice? Now let's take some white and a touch of cobalt blue, and let's put some of that nice bluey whitey color here and there on some of the branches. Okay, so let's just leave that settle in between some of the branches just like that. So there's snow gathering on some of the branches as well. Isn't that lovely? This is really fun. I hope you're enjoying my new channel, by the way, Easy Oil Painting. I'm getting some fantastic compliments. And thank you very much for all those compliments and your encouragement, because believe it or not, your encouragement really helps me along, because I'm not a very confident kind of a guy, to be quite honest. I'm usually quite kind of reserved in that manner. I don't like kind of putting myself out there in the public too much. So yeah, thank you so much for giving me all this confidence with your lovely comments. And it's pushing me to go better and do more and more tutorials, and do better tutorials as well. So I appreciate that. Thank you very much. I do appreciate all your feedback, I promise. So keep it up. You know, I'm learning all the time as well. There we go. Now, a bit of white on that, look. How's that now for a nice little tree with some snow? Isn't that lovely? Let's just sit that down now again, the very same way we've done with the others. A little bit of white, a little touch of Naples yellow perhaps. And let's just put some snow in under that there. And let's sit that down. Sit down, tree. There, soften it up into the tree. Pull it down. Now let me just get a bit more. I just want to create a little mound of snow just at the base of the tree here. And then of course we have a shadow, don't we? We must put a shadow in there. So some phthalo blue, some crimson and a touch of black. And let's create a little shadow coming off the tree just like that. And soften it in with your finger. There. Or your fan brush or your soft blender brush, whichever you like. And that's that. Let me have a look now. Let's put in. All right, I suppose it's not going to be a Stephen Conway painting without a few birds, is it? Yes? Come on, let's put in a couple of little birds up here, flying towards us. Three birds. Three is always a good number, isn't it? And we can also, if you want, do an extra bit of work just on the cabin here and there. Let's add little touches of light, little details, small details. You see, just little subtle details. Let's add a little touch of one on the edge here. Perhaps just coming down here. Little touches of snow, that type of thing. We could add a little touch of snow on the tip of this one, kind of falling down. All right, that's not bad, that's okay. I'm happy with that. I'll define some of the line here. Then I'll get some nice dark color and I'll add a little dark into some of these here just to really push that into the shadow there. You could even add a touch of blue into this if you wanted as well. That would make a lovely deep kind of a shadow here in this corner. Let's take a touch of phthalo blue. All right, that's fine. And let's see, what else could we lighten up on this or darken? Let's darken this line down here. We could even darken some of the lines on these logs here. Okay. How's that looking? Pretty good, I would say. Let me zoom back and take a look. Now, how about that? So I'll zoom in now, let's have a good look around. See if there's anything else there that you might like to work on. Okay, I'm very happy with the mountain, that's quite nice. Pan over to our next mountain there, nice and simple. So we're coming down then. Lovely trees in the distance. And remember how simple those bushes were? Just nice, easy little dabs of paint on the tip of your brush. And let's come across here to the cabin. Little impression of a footpath. Some more lovely bushes. You zoom in slightly so you can see. Just dabs of white paint on the tip of your brush, that's all it is. See? Isn't that lovely? I must say now I'm very, very, very happy with that. And I suppose I'd better sign it, hadn't I? Okay, let me get some black paint on my little brush here. And I will try and put this up now for sale, see if anyone can buy this. If you're a wealthy millionaire, come on, you know my address, my email address. Buy this lovely painting off of me and hang it in your home, in your lovely home. There we go. Look at that. Lovely. So look, I turn the camera here just so you can see myself. There we are. You can look down on me. Here. Okay. Right, that's it. Job done. Snow scene number 3 finished. I really enjoy this. I'm gonna put a frame on this now and see if I can sell this. This is a lovely one. I might even hang it in my own house, who knows. Next week I'm going to do a lovely, I promised someone I would try and paint a lovely mountain, rocky kind of a mountain, similar technique to this now but in a kind of a summery scene, so kind of goldy sandy coloured mountain kind of coming down, something like that. And then I have one or two other requests I need to get through. I might start another series on reflections perhaps after that. So look, we're getting through the requests one by one. And I'm doing them as much as I can. I'm trying to fit the requests and suggestions in with the other stuff that I'm trying to get on my channel as well at the same time. So it takes a couple of weeks for me to get through each one. Do you understand what I mean? So, but look, keep them coming. And if you have any questions, just email me at stephenconway12@gmail.com. Also, if you want those brushes, the same email. And thank you so much for your help and your support and your confidence in me. And thanks for tuning into my channel, Easy Oil Painting. Let's get it famous. We make our own little TV series, shall we? Let's go. Share all these and subscribe. And I'll see you back here next week. So don't go anywhere and happy painting, all right? God bless.